You know, because we all have the capability of going right back to the slop we came from. And you know what? When somebody does get out of that slop, don't say, well, he's gonna go back. Pray that he don't go back. Pray that he stays out of that slop. You know, because every one of us has been that same hole, with just in a different trough. You know, it's just a different, everybody's got something that they do before they change. Before they finally meet Jesus Christ. And that's the only change you're going to get, is him. Because without him, we're nothing. You know, we think we are sometimes, but we're not. And we never will be. Because without him, our quality of life is so nothing. But he can change it in a twinkling of an eye. I know I can look around this room and see people that I used to do things with and see people doing things that I don't no longer do. And I know in one night, he took my thirst of alcohol away. And I know if he can do that for me, he can do it for anybody. And he will if you'll ask. He'll straighten you up and he'll show you which way to go. All you gotta do is ask for the directions and he'll guide you through it. I know, is any birthdays or anniversaries this week?
No,
we got some too last week. That was a double there. And there was a whole bunch of us. I put on Facebook, there's a whole bunch of us shared that day. And, you know, I enjoyed mine, and I hope to enjoy the next one. And the next one. But I may not get the next one. But you know, if I don't get the next one, I'm going somewhere nice. It ain't gonna be where I gotta worry about putting on Carhartts in the wintertime or taking off down in my bikini in the summer to keep going. You know what? It's gonna be wonderful. And it ain't gonna be no hot sunshine. The light is gonna be the Son of God. Jesus Christ is gonna be the one that lights up that place. He lights up this place today. But he uses something that he left here for us. But when it's all over for us, he'll be the light. He'll be our everything, just like he is now. But we'll be part of him, just like we are now if we're saved. But we've got to act like we're part of him while we're here, as well as when we get there. Well, we're going to move right along to prayer request this morning. I know we have quite a few back here.
My brother-in-law will start dialysis this week.
What was his name?
Chris Skaggs. Skaggs.
Bill Barnett that's in Madisonville Hospital and they can't, he's been having chest pains and having a hard time breathing and they can't figure out what's wrong with him. And I read on Facebook this morning that they're going to run some more tests tomorrow to try to figure out what's wrong with him.
Chest pains, he couldn't hardly breathe. He's still
desire to go down there. I'm a north girl and a mountain girl.
Robin needs to be put on the list too.
Okay.
I just wanna say, keep our family in everybody's prayers, because we're doing good now, and we want to continue to do, and I praise the Lord for everything that He has done for us. Son's doing a lot better, but it's still gonna be a long time. I don't know if he'll ever be back tomorrow, but at least he's here.
My dad Walter, keep him in our prayers.
Art, Fergin, is that right?
Fergin.
Art?
Noble, I just talked to Christie a while ago, and she's gonna have surgery Tuesday, but she also told me they're gonna take her spleen out. So, I don't know why, but. I want the mystery to me anymore.
Mary Lou?
No, Mary Lou's got me.
My sister sent a copy, she may already have her on there, but they found some type of tumor or something in her lung, and she's scheduled to have some type of test done this coming year.
Eugene?
Yeah.
No, she, the last word that I heard was last night that they had called in hospice already, and spoke with him yesterday. He said, you know, he understands, it's just a matter of time. And like I said back here, some people don't understand. I didn't completely understand. He told me, he said, you know, he said, I'm just praying, Lord, just go ahead and take her. And I know that feeling all too well. I did the same thing for my dad, you know, because it just comes a point in time that, you know, you don't want them to suffer, especially if you know they're ready to take the Lord. So it's difficult, but, you know, we just need to keep their whole family in prayer.
Sister Melissa.
My husband and his brother, they lost their mother last weekend.
Who?
My husband Brian Thomas and his brother, they lost their mother last weekend.
Keep Sue in your prayers, and then Ron's daughter, Rhonda, and then I have an unspoken request.
I'd like prayer for my husband. He's got COPD, and I was just praying the Holy Spirit breathe on him and breathe in him.
That's Skeeter, right?
That's Skeeter.
What do I know?
Everybody knows Skeeter.
Abby won't do it, but she wants her brother James to put it on the list.
Anybody else?
Keep dad in prayer as always. He's not here this morning. And the ministry of Teen Challenge in any ministry life. You know, I was talking to somebody this morning. There's going to be a new young man coming in next week. It's just that's an awesome, awesome ministry. You know, God does the work. That's cool that God uses. And it teaches you how to have a relationship with Christ and how to have a relationship. And it was a game changer for me. And that's why I'm a part of it. And just got some some new guys coming in, and just keep that ministry lifted up.
Thank you.
morning.
Good morning.
Morning. Y'all by the week yet? We're gonna get there here pretty quick. I do have one announcement to make. And again, y'all probably seen this. If you've been out here before, Eternal Vision's been out here and sing to us one time before. And it's coming Sunday on the 4th.
Yep.
If they're going to be out here, it's going to be regular church time. That's going to be our service for that day. And I know the last time they came was at 8 o'clock or 9 that we showed up to help them set up.
Well, they'll want to be here 2 hours early, so they'll be here at least by 9.
Yeah. By 9, okay. Like I say, I'll make sure I'm up here myself, and anybody that's willing to come up and help them get set up and whatnot, it'd be a blessing. And I know several of us that were up here, Brother Jagadell can very much testify to this, and they were just up here getting their vocals together while they were setting up. It was already getting thick in here, so it's going to be a blessed time. Again, you know, I'm going to put this on my Facebook page as well, and I know several others have. But by all means, stop up here and take a look at this and make it a point, you know, especially next Sunday to come out, because they're a fantastic group and you're going to be blessed by them, I guarantee you that. Amen.
Everybody, everyone bring one. Everybody bring one. Bring a friend that's never been here before.
Amen.
Come see our church.
Everybody bring one out with you. We're going to start out, of course, like we do on Sunday morning with our penny march for our children. And we're going to be on page 191. Page 191. Y'all pick up your books and stand and sing with us if you would. Jesus loves me. Here goes this. Amen. Everybody on 191 yet? Amen. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to Him belong, they are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me. Just in chapter 61. Page 61. Let's go that direction. Can't help that preacher keep trying to come out of it.
He's getting ready to go to the Bible.
Amen. Page 61. You know, there's going to come a time when we are going to get to go home and see that mansion He's prepared for. Amen. Amen. Everybody on 61?
I've a home prepared where the saints abide, just over in the glory land. And I long to be by my Savior's side, just over in the glory land. Just over in the glory land, I'll join the happy angel band. Just over in the glory land.
wanted to sing this morning. Page 256. Page 256. And you know, if it wasn't for this amazing grace, we wouldn't have anything to stand up here for. Not by anybody, not by anything that we've done on our own. Only by the grace of God are we still here. Only by the grace of God are we still blessed the way that we're blessed. Not by anything that we do on our own. Amen. Page 256, Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet.
Thank you.
singing this morning? You don't want to this morning? Sis, you got your song?
Yeah. I didn't practice the song, though.
Huh? He didn't practice the song.
Didn't practice it?
He didn't practice.
I'm going to try to say do this without music. And if I mess up, y'all probably won't know the difference.
No, sorry.
Last night I dreamed I took a walk up Calvary's lonely hill. The things I saw with my own eyes could not have been. Breaking up.